3, 2, 1, go for it.
Hi there, Geop here. How you doing, Father? You doing good today?
Doing great.
Yeah, I'm glad you're doing good. So I got a question for you, Father.
Uh-huh.
So have you ever heard of something called butt oil?
Yes, I
do you have a problem with butt oil?
As a priest, maybe.
Well, I can't help you with that. But you know what I can help you with?
Uh-huh.
If you have a butt oil problem, mm-hmm. maybe I can offer you some chair oil. It's always sitting in the chair. I mean, you're a priest. You're on your feet all the time. When you sit down, you don't want to have an oily butt sitting on a chair. No, you want to have a, well, the oil works in the chair is the bottom line. So you got a leaky butt. Back to the leaky butt. You have a problem. There a problem in the pew when you're talking about the pew, but everybody in the church just saying pu. Boy, howdy! I got a solution here. I mean, you just oil. You sit down. People won't know you got an oily butt. It won't smell bad at all. I mean,
if you're having a bit of a swamp.
I think I've made my case here. What do you say
problem?
Here, Father? Have I sold you on your swamp bottom problems with the chair oil
that's
by
time.
Geop
that's,
Co.
That's time. All right, who would like to sell me a product next? Should we just go clockwise?
Yeah, I guess we could just go in order.
All right, Vicas, I will start you off in 3, 2, 1, do it.
All right, Father, can I call you Father?
Yeah, absolutely.
Father, I know that you're the kind of guy who likes to just give hours and hours of sermons, aren't you?
That's my thing, yeah.
And when you give the sermons, you get real worked up, right? Like fucking praising the Lord, like throwing your body all over the place, am I right?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I feel like that can get kind of tiring, don't you think? Like, you need a lot of I don't know, mass on you. You need to really bulk up to be able to scream and hoot and holler for hours at a mm-hmm. time, wouldn't you say?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, I think I got exactly what you need here. What you need is a muscle bulb. This thing is your one-stop shop. You can work out absolutely any muscle you want. Your glutes, your legs, your tibia, anything. If it helps you preach.
The tibia muscle, yes.
Yes, good, the tibia muscle.
It's a good muscle. So what is a muscle bulb? How does it work? What do I do with it?
Well, you see, with the muscle bulb, you simply attach it to the muscle that you want to work out. And then walk around for about like 10 miles, maybe do 50 push-ups. Uh-huh. And the results that you will see with this thing are beyond incredible. Like,
hey, that's time. yes, the muscle bulb.
Yes, the All muscle right. bulb.
Andy, do you have your idea?
Yeah.
All right, go.
Padre, how's your sermons been recently?
Solid, as per always.
Have you ever noticed that it's difficult to get the younger generation's attention these times?
Millennials.
These years?
Millennials, man. They're killing the pews.
They're, they're just too busy looking at their phones instead of praising the Lord, so.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a solution for that.
Uh-huh.
The trick is not just try and relate to them on a personal level. No. Children are essentially animals. They have no concept of right and wrong. Okay. They're only interested in visual effects.
All right.
To that, I introduce the solution. Mouse costume. Imagine a tiny mouse explaining the wonders of the Stations of the Cross. Even though mice can't speak, the kids will certainly be enraptured by the struggles of Jesus Christ, as spoken by a tiny... tiny little mouse. You saw the Super Bowl, Padre. You saw the Super Bowl. You know how endearing that shark became. You could be the next viral sensation. Please buy mouse costume. Thank you.
Wow. And under time.
Elevator pitch.
Wow. That's real solid. I don't know how to stop it. So That's unfortunate.
No, it's just going to run its course.
You
got to percolate on it.
I mean, I got to be honest. I could go for a mouse costume. I
mean, that was, yeah.
That's understandable.
That was a really good pitch. The children love it.
You there with a rotating card.
Yes, yes.
But I sell you on a new product, sir.
Perhaps so.
You've been out in the field trying to get a scoop, right?
Always.
But those pesky celebrities keep attacking you and they keep beating you up and there's no way to fight back.
It's been known to happen, yes.
Well, sir, have I got the solution for you? Introducing the razor pen.
Okay.
If you're writing notes on a celebrity and they refuse to let you write notes on them, you just fucking stab them. Just fucking right in their fucking heart. They won't live. Nobody will believe you because it's just a pen. Nobody's going to look for a razor in a pen. All you need. Just two quick strikes to the heart. You can even go for the jugular. Just fucking just go straight. Just make sure no one's around. Don't. Okay, hold on. Hang on. Wait, those other two guys at the table, are they listening right now?
Definitely not.
Are you listening right now? That's what I thought. Just quick little slash right across the neck. They go to sleep. They never wake up.
What's like the without action on this thing?
Instant. It's actually just a razor glued to the end of a pen.
Vicas is
no one will expect it.
Vicas is a paparazzi, by the way.
Remember, we never had this conversation.
And scene.
Woo. All right.
Geop.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Possibly.
Go.
I might have a working pair. Okay, hi, how you doing, sir? Oh, how you doing? You find any celebrities today? Well, that's fantastic. So I got a question. Whenever you're cruising down Rodeo Drive and you snap a pic of Tom Cruise or whoever all the youngsters are hooting and hollering over, do you ever find yourself having to make a fast getaway?
Yes, I've definitely had the cops called on me.
Have you ever had problems escaping, my friend?
Once or twice.
Well, let me tell you something. There is a vehicle of choice that's been passed over from days gone by. They say you cannot use it in the urban jungle. They say you cannot use it on the rough terrain. But let me tell you, my friend, a sled is still incredibly, incredibly, well, possibly usable, but... The thing is, oh, I've got a beeping going off, but that is the deal. Because you are in luck. For I am selling sled. Oh, lube. Yes, sled lube.
So wait, do I get away. The sled?
Sleds are still perfectly usable. You just have to lube them on up, slide on down the sidewalk. You'll be making your getaway, my friend. So say, have I sold you or have I sold you, friend? I don't even know why I have this accent.
Geoff, go take out your chicken before it burns.
Yeah, please tend to your my rice smoke cooker. Detector.
I'm sorry.
All right,
No, it fit perfectly.
Deal alarm.
All right, I'm ready.
Ready, Ty?
I'm ready.
All right, go.
All right, so you're a paparazzi. What's the hardest part of being a paparazzi? Well, it's tracking people down, right? And on top of that, what's the best kind of pictures? What always kicks up the biggest fuss and sells for the most? That's right, people fucking. So what if I told you we could get to fuck in a place that you're already ready for?
What the?
That's right. That's why we have the deployable Love Beach. Just throw it out wherever. Just find yourself a regular ass beach, plop a Love Beach down on top of it, really spruce it up a bit, and the fuck will come to you. They will make fuck where you are. It saves so much time. Celebrities can't stay away. Just find half a celebrity and it just puts itself together. Get your camera out. Just lay out solid. You're set. It's free money for a paparazzi like yourself.
How much cleanup is involved?
Well, that's the good thing about the Love Beach. It's a deployable thing, so you can just fold it right back up, throw it away. It's a one-time use. It's disposable, as most love-related products probably should be. But like, you put it down, get your pictures. You're making $20,000 off, you know, one really good fuck pic. And let's just say, this thing right here, $29.99
for what could be an entire fuck pic. Oh my god, I have just... That's just filled with possibilities here. What could I possibly take for my busy paparazzi lifestyle? The murder pen? The getaway lube? Or the fuck beach?
You see me doing the love flourish beach, motion with
love
my hand?
Beach. We would have to... We wouldn't be able to sell it if it said fuck, actually, in the U.S.
Oh, sorry, the frick beach.
The whoopee beach.
You know what? I think that actually I have a sled in my backyard, and you have sold me, sir. Oh, hey. Kindly just put that in your hand. I slid Mercy. It straight into your pocket.
One pitch.
All right, so you're a tree hugger, right? You care about the environment. You're trying to be... let's say you're trying to take it to the next level and you want to really be personal. You still want eggs because eggs are great, but you don't want to have eggs, you know, chickens living in cages. You know, you want to make sure they're free range, but you can't really trust it because, you know, organic doesn't really mean anything. People lie on free range labels all the time. They're like, oh, well, these cages are 1 cubic inch larger, you know, so that's what that means. So how can you, Andy, the tree hugger, be sure that your chickens are free range? Well, you have a house cock. You just have your own. You just have your own house cock. Just keep it in the house. Then you know exactly how free of a range it's in.
My own cock.
Your own cock. You can start working towards subsistence farming. You can start being zero impact. What's a carbon footprint? Oh, smaller than your house cocks, probably. That's what you're working on, buddy. So that's my pitch. Get a house cock.
I'll have to think about it.
Always think about that cock.
And you can just right click and do the arrow again and it should reset it.
Oh, that just restarts it. Okay, Vicas, you're next?
Sure thing.
Alright, 3, 2, 1, pitch me.
All right, so as a tree hugger, I imagine that you're always going out into the wilderness and, you know, getting down and dirty. Am I right?
Generally going out for hugs, yeah.
You gotta really get in there, kind of get that sap, like, all over your shirt, right?
Yeah, like, I can't hug the bigger ones.
I have to imagine you have been, if you'll pardon my French, shat on by a squirrel or two, or maybe even a pigeon.
I hate them.
And the thing is, it can be so hard to go home and find a detergent that is as natural as those trees that you just love so much. But have I got the thing for you? See, I have two words, and don't stand up, you'll just sit right back down. Odor sponge. Mm. You can apply this thing to anything. It will suck out all of the juicy, disgusting pigeon shit from anything. Honestly, you may not ever have to go home again because you will literally be able to use this in place of showers, in place of baths. You won't even have to jump into a clear, beautiful stream once you have the odor sponge.
Awesome. My habit of not bathing is paying off already.
Exactly. You will never have to bathe again, sir. What do you say?
I'll think about it.
Odor sponge.
All right, Geop, you ready?
Yes, I am.
All right, 3, 2, 1, pitch.
Howdy, my friend. I can see you are in tune with the environment, and I assume you are also in tune with modern culture. But also, you ever go to Woodstock? You look like a Woodstock guy. What are you, about 60 years old-ish? Something about?
I wish.
Yeah, Yeah, I thought so. So what are you driving exactly? You got one of them old beat up cars you see all the people have? Like, what is it?
I have a hybrid bike that I built from an animal that was messing around with the tree I love.
Oh,
damn.
Well, I appear to be in a bit of an awkward spot because, you see, if you happen to have an old style van from back when Woodstock was still a thing, why, I would be able to sell you a van door.
Just one door.
I don't have a door yet. I've always wanted to join the door.
Do I have a deal for you, my friend? You see, this is, you could easily install this on any sorts of means on your bicycle. You see, the coupling are completely biodegradable. Biodegradable, son! So you see, you could use anything. What's something biodegradable? Plastic. Plastic's biodegradable, right? Right. You could use plastic. You know it. You could tie it to your bicycle with plastic. Yes, I'm a man of science. Trust me, my friend. I was really hoping you'd have some sort of a hippie van thing. That's what I was going for.
Prize, motherfucker. Van door.
Shit, he's a new age hippie.
Do I want to give the van door, housecock, or odor sponge? I kind of feel like the tree hugger would want the odor sponge most of all.
I 100% agree.
Okay, I'm glad you didn't bring the housecock. It took me a second, but I was like, oh shit, that implies a male one, and they do not lay eggs.
I wasn't going to say it. Like, I was thinking that the entire time, but I wasn't going to say it.
Start.
All right, so you're down at the beach, right? And you know, like, beaches aren't quite as clean as they used to be, you know, millennials. There's a lot of glass. There's a lot of creatures. You know, there's just a lot of things that you could really cut yourself up on, right? Like, you could really hurt yourself out on the beach these days. It's a little unfortunate. But how do you protect your feet? Some people would say sandals. You know, that's a reasonable expectation. Some say water shoes. But here's the thing. Water shoes work better. Sandals don't quite protect you all the way. But no one wants to fuck a guy in water shoes. You know, like, no one does. Right? Like, right? That's a thing. So here's what I got. All right? Desire socks. You cover your feet, you keep yourself good. They come in all sorts of prints, all the prints you need, everything you want. Ladies love a man in desire socks.
What are they made out of?
What are they made out of? That's a great question. So it's a hydrophobic, breathable mesh, so they stay perfectly dry. As soon as you come out, bam, dry socks. They would have killed for these in Vietnam, let me tell you. And you're going to love them at the beach. Just like the time you dodged Vietnam. You would have known you needed them if you weren't there. But I understand.
We're supposed to tell everybody about that.
Desire socks. They're here for you. Keep your feet safe. Keep your feet dry. Still get laid. Desire socks.
But are they designer desire socks?
Yes.
World may never know.
You just mashing it for no reason.
Right, I can't believe you've given us this power.
Is Vicas next, I guess?
Yeah,
I am in fact Vicas. Ready. So
are you ready?
Count me in.
Okay. 3, 2, 1. Sell me.
Mr. Nerd, may I call you Guess again?
Maybe.
All right. Well, when you're on the beach, when you were just cruising around, seeing some hotties, what's the first thing that you think?
I'm hungry.
Okay. Actually, it's fuck.
That's actually fuck. The third thing on my mind. How'd you know that?
And sir, if you want to fuck, and of course, you want to fuck, what I have for you is a fuck magnet. With this product, you will get so much fuck. It will be incredible. Like, oceans and oceans of fuck. You're a beach guy. Am I right? Am I right in thinking that?
Yeah, from time to time.
You understand the ocean. The ocean is a lot of water. What I'm selling you here is a lot of fuck.
Is it a fuckload?
It is a fuckload of fuck. It will get you. It will attract the fuck to you. So much fuck. You, as a beach bum, love the fuck.
So fuck.
So fuck. Much fuck. Wow.
A whole ocean of fuck.
An ocean of fuck.
By the fuck.
I don't know what to say. I actually don't know what to say.
Good, because I'm out of ways to say fuck, and my time is done. Oh, damn it, I missed it. It's a free fuck, Jim.
All right.
Andy. So, Andy.
I'm ready.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, go.
Hey, man. How's it going?
It's going, no.
Just enjoying a nice little day at the beach, right?
Yeah, nice tan.
Problem is, they don't let you keep roaches at the beach, if you know what I'm saying, right?
What?
You know what I'm getting at?
You don't go
to the beach just to enjoy the reefer, right? You know what I mean?
I enjoy the coral reefs, if that's what you mean.
Yeah, well, you know how the police, they're just constantly on your ass when you're just trying to have a nice day, maybe enjoy a weed with a friend, right?
Well, maybe when I was in college, yeah, I mean, you know.
I've got the solution for you, my friend.
You have to say yes, it's the law.
I'm not a cop, don't worry, man. Introducing the Beach Bum Bubble Bomb. To anybody else on the beach, they'll just think you're playing with a little bubble gun. You're gonna be using the beach bum bubble bong and getting mad ripped. You'll get fucking destroyed, man. Trust me. My buddy, he works down at the docks. He has two of these. He takes them everywhere. People don't know he's even bringing the beach bum bubble bong.
Does he use two beach bum bubble bongs at the same time?
He's my beach bum bubble bong brother.
Beach bum bubble bong ambidextrous.
Time. Time bong boy. Also, thank you to Fort Kid for the sub.
Go. All right, Mr. Tuesday, I have an offer for you.
Mm-hmm.
You know how the prisoners, they really like to keep their little knickknacks, and that, you know, they can be a bit of a boisterous bunch, don't you think?
Yeah, yeah, always smuggling shit behind posters, yeah.
Oh, just constantly. And I think that if you really want to be a successful prison guard, and I mean, I did 3 years down in Louisiana, trust me, I know what I'm talking about here.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You really need to get on their good side, because they can be a rowdy bunch of boys.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that if you ever want to, I'm not going to say bribe, but if you ever want to bribe a prisoner to get on his good side,
yep.
What you really need is a sort of poster.
All right.
And what better poster? Like, I happen to know everything that prisoners are all about.
Yeah.
Wow, I just fucking threw that thing. How about a pony poster?
Uh-huh.
So there's this TV show going around called My Little Pony.
Yeah.
And as far as all of my metrics indicate, prisoners fucking love it. Down in Louisiana, they would just show up every single day in the mess hall to watch My Little Pony. They were a bunch of regular bronies.
Love this thing. I do not think those are the prisoners I need to bribe. I am sorry. All right, Andy, what do you got for me?
Man, I had no idea I could do this.
Oh, shit, you started the timer.
Oh, I can start again. I can start again. Go.
Okay, yeah. Evening, Warden. How are you doing?
Doing all right.
So, prisoners, they kind of suck, right? Like, they're just no fun. You're trying to organize exercise time, activity time. They're just, they're all so mad. Like they just don't want to do anything. They hate cooperating with you. Why not introduce a little bit of fun to what you do?
Mm-hmm.
I give you the bread cannon. Imagine if you will, it's breakfast time. All the prisoners are just having their breakfast, probably swearing a lot. Maybe there's a fight going on. You start shooting bread at them, they're gonna scatter. Some are going to try and catch it in their mouths. They're going to try and jump up like small birds, pecking and poking at the floor to try and pick up the loose crumbs that the other prisoners didn't catch. Others will be flying and running away for cover, thinking that you've finally gone rogue. If you purchase, hold on, I'm not done. If you purchase our added-on loaf launcher, I'll throw in a second cannon. Absolutely free. You can launch loaves, entire loaves. You can shoot them from the roof. You can shoot them from the lunchroom. You can shoot them into their cells. Because this cannon fires at such a velocity that they will die if any of this bread touches them.
Hmm.
The bread cannon.
All right. Geop, are you ready?
Yes, I am ready.
All right, go for it.
Hello, officer. I have a question for you. From my understanding, you work in a very, very dangerous cell block, correct?
Yes.
Yes. I mean, I know you have a number of murderers and killers. It's very, very dangerous and as a whole.
Yes.
The officers are not very well liked. I'm sure you know this.
Mm-hmm.
So recently there's been a, there's been a prisoner by the name of Little Huggles who's been very friendly, you know. You know, he's an okay guy, you know. He's your pal. He's helping out, doing little errands, you know, good behavior sort of thing. Maybe parole or something of the sort. But I'm here to sell you something, my friend.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not something materialistic.
Okay.
What I'm here to sell you is information.
Ah.
He wants to meet you. He wants to meet you tomorrow, I have heard, in a secret location off the side.
All
but the thing is, he has procured a weapon, and I advise you do not go. What I'm selling you is information, my friend, because it is a trap, Ty. Don't do it. That's all I'm selling. Are you picking up what I'm putting down?
Also, fucking thank you for the donation, an idiot with no taste. Oh, good. All of the fuck talk has caused the beepus alarm to go off. I hope you're all proud of yourselves. And
here
holy
comes
shit,
the beautiful beepus.
Robo Mythos. That art is beautiful. That dog's expression is perfect. Damn, like. Man, you know, like, I was all about the bread cannon, but, like, man, I was real caught off guard by the trap tie. Man, I gotta give it to trap tie. That was...
out of nowhere.
That was artwork, is what that was. Holy cow.
Go.
Good evening, sir. How are you today?
Everything hurts.
What are you, 21, 22?
73.
That's a shame. Have you ever woken up in the morning and found a bunch of criminals in your room? All the time, right?
The 1940s, yes.
It's a pretty common problem, but I've got the solution for that. It's called the gun bed. If you purchase the gun bed, we will mount in auto guns, mini guns, auto cannons, grenade launchers. We will mount a pistol. We will mount any kind of gun you want to your bed. And it also comes with a free recliner as well. The mattress reclines, it extends, and it also has a gun in it. It can be whatever kind of boy you want. He can be hardworking, he can be lazy, he can be whatever kind of boy. The thing is, sir, this bed has an incalculable amount of guns. There are so many guns in this bed. You're actually just sleeping on guns. There is no mattress. It's just more guns. Now, I would also like to sell you on the ammo plan for the gun bed, because you imagine.
I was wondering.
It uses a lot of ammunition. But the thing is, if you buy the gun bed right now in the next 17 seconds, we'll throw in 1 year of ammo for only $67,000 a day.
Ooh.
The choice is yours, but can you really put a price on your security? Please.
Can I use my social security check?
You can use any check you want. We'll take anything.
Gun bed.
Gun bed.
The bed that shoots people.
You're ready, Geop.
Thank you, Tom.
Yeah.
Our bed has more guns than that.
I think I'm ready.
All right, then I will start the timer in 3, 2, 1, go.
Hello, sir. I have a question for you. How old are you right now?
82.
Ooh, mercy. So my math is terrible right now, but have you served for our country at some point? Are you a veteran, sir?
I'm not legally obliged, but let's say the answer is yes.
Yes, okay. Are you appreciative of freedom, my friend?
I greatly enjoy freedom, yes.
Do you love everything this country stands for?
I am old enough to be required to.
Well, I have another question for you. Let me hit you from a different angle here. Do you have restroom-related issues, my friend? I have a father about your age, and I have to help him out from time to time. You know, you get old, and these things become difficult.
Oh, my.
You can confide in me. Do you have issues? Do you need care in that sort of... Well, let me tell you something. I have the answer to all your problems, because if you buy this patriotic product... The freedom flap.
Oh, no.
It will allow you to give expedient egress of your waste material. Installable into any britches you could find, front, back, behind. That's the deal.
Does it come in American flag? Going off again.
That's the deal alarm going off again. Can you hear it?
Every time you pitch.
I didn't know how to work into that. I was just thinking like American pattern underwear, and I was just like, fuck.
All right.
You ready, Ty?
Mm-hmm.
All right, you're going in 3, 2, 1, go.
So you're a little advanced in years, and I know it can be hard, right, to get with all of your friends and whatnot, especially because everyone has their own medical conditions.
Everything is hard.
One of the biggest ones is, you know, people have issues with their hearts. People have issues, you know, breathing. So a lot of people have to have their oxygen containers around with them. And you can't have anything too exciting, but you still want an excuse. Because, you know, even in your advanced stage, you still need to have a reason for people to gather, right? So you want to keep your friends safe. You want clean air. And you want to be able to enjoy each other's presence, but not get too worked up. Well, good news, my friend. Plant party. It is...
Tell me about the plant party.
All the fun of looking at your favorite plants, such as ficus, cactus, ficus.
I love fici.
Mm-hmm. All sorts of plants. We've got them all. The air is going to be so clean in your home. Everybody's going to be having a jolly time. You can have cheese trays, but not too many. You can have fruit trays, but, you know, keep the insulin nearby. But party. Plant party. You're going to have a great time. Your friends love plants. How many of your friends love plants? You know what else is a plant?
All of them.
You know. Mm-hmm. You know what else is a plant.
Oh.
You won't get arrested. You're 83. No one will arrest an 83-year-old smoking weed. I'm just saying. Have a hell of a plant party with your friends.
That kind of plant.
You're
going to
die
party.
Soon?
You're going to die soon, just face to black.
Plant party.
Plant party.
You're gonna die.
Time to stop being a Tito Taller and fucking toke up, old man.
Tito Taller.
Ooh, okay. Shit.
Exactly.
Do I want the guns?
Freedom flap.
Do I want the shit pants? Or do I want to smoke some dank weed?
Makes it sounds pretty easy when you put it like that.
It's a good point.
Yeah. I'd vote for that.
The least exciting party of all. Or the most exciting.
All right.
So, Andy, for a start, are you going to be a legal pimp or an illegal pimp?
Important.
That's for the courts to decide. It's funny because it's all right, you ready, Geo?
Yeah.
All right, 3, 2, 1, pip.
Hey, how's it going, buddy? Don't hit me. How's business been doing for you recently, sir?
Not great. My stock in gun bed went down recently, so.
I heard about that. It's terrible. It's not selling well to seniors. But in your other business, I understand that you procure pleasures of the flesh, as some might call it in some parts.
Who wants to know?
Well, I'm not a cop, and I've just said it, so therefore I have proven I am not a police officer. And I'm
pulling my gun on you right now.
Well, I have. Let me just throw this down right in front of you. Screw grenade.
Tell me more.
Percolate on them words. Are you coming to a boil?
It's making me.
Well, let me tell you. You throw this down, and boom, you'll have people wanting to screw everywhere. I mean, you might have some mechanics and things, you know, because it's just there's a lot of types of screw. But you're gonna have somebody who's gonna want to, you know, get a little.
That tends to be a problem in my profession.
Not that I know what your profession is, but, you know, a screw grenade may or may not be what a totally legal and trustworthy member contributing to society might desire. So, sir, might you be interested in the screw grenade? The deal alarm's going off right now.
Geop,
that's it right there.
Geop, why do you turn into Foghorn Leghorn every time you sell something?
I don't know. I start. That's, my
you just
accent,
gotta cultivate a persona. You
my
know?
Accent goes out of control, and then it just warps.
That's fair. All right, I'm
That's
ready.
Just what happens. I mean, you know, I'm when you ready. Get in the zone.
I'm ready.
All right. Hang on. I can't zoom out on the clock enough. There we go. Three. It's too large. Three, two, one. Pimp.
All right, so you're a pimp, and you have to deal with a lot of clientele, and there are some inherent risks to being a pimp. Now, this is nothing new. You know, like, syphilis has been a thing since the beginning of time. You got to be worried. Some are bacterial, you know, and that's kind of the thing. But
you,
the question,
you can't shoot it.
Yeah, and curing that kind of stuff in post, you know, that's going to leave, you know, one of your workers out of commission for, you know, weeks, you know, if not more. If you're being safe and you want to make sure that your clientele is doing well, that's how you get repeat customers. You know, you got to keep everyone safe. So what if I told you that there is a much faster way than penicillin or modern medicine?
Tell me more.
Immediately here. Bacteria plunger. Just rip it on out. You just slug it on. Pull it right out, unclogged in a second. You're just going to be, bam, clean as a whistle, ready to go. People don't think of it. They think physical force? That won't work. You'd be amazed.
And this works for all models.
All models. Both sides. Mm-hmm. Does not matter. Whatever you need cleaned, just, bam, rip it right out of them. Get them back to work.
Just plunge it out. Clears out all clogs.
Just plunge it out.
Like every clog?
Technically, it pushes it through all the way, which leads to it's. You'll want to wear some plastic sheets, but
because I've had to pull stuff out.
Mm-hmm. It will. It's great. You're gonna love the bacteria plunger.
I got a question. Does that remove toxins? I'm asking for a friend.
All right, Vicas.
You ready, Vicas?
All right, let's do this.
Three, two, one, pimp.
Now, sir, I'm sure that you've heard the old adage. We all know it. We all love it. A pimp is only as good as his tools.
Mm-hmm.
You need to offer new types of products to the customer. And I'm not saying that your stock is anything other than absolutely pristine. But sometimes you got to really wow them with a new kind of experience. You know what I mean?
Got to shake things up, yeah.
You gotta change everything up from time to time. You got to offer your customers a new kind of experience. The sort of thing that they've never heard for, that they've never seen before in their lives, that they've never experienced.
There's got to be a better way.
There has got to be a better way. I agree. Imagine if you could do your business from miles and miles away. Well, let me introduce you to Vibrator Torpedo. You can fire this thing from a cruiser 3 miles away from the coast, and you will hit your target, and 100% satisfaction guaranteed.
Do you have combat data? Has this been used in live combat?
Yes. What? And I'm not allowed to tell results? You about the I'm not allowed to give you the casualties report because that's still up to the courts to decide. But let me tell you, those who made it through, 100% satisfaction.
The vibrator torpedo, the screw grenade, Jesus Christ.
Or the bacteria plunger.
Jesus, by the way, chat, thank you for noticing my spinning card.
I think I gotta give this one to the vibrator tornado.
Yeah.
Oh god, you said
that's
tornado.
Actually my Mega Man voice.
Tornado. Oh, what was torpedo?
It is torpedo. I just read it wrong.
Oh my god, a vibrator tornado? Holy shit.
Go.
Alright, you're a kid. Let's just be honest. What's the funniest thing to a child? Animal sack. I'm done. That's my pitch. Animal nuts. You can kick them. You can do what you want. You can just hang them on stuff. Laugh at them. It's just an animal sack. What's funnier than a balls? Nothing. Nothing is funnier than a balls. I'm done. That's it. That's my pitch. The end.
Damn. That is some elevator pitch shit right there.
My dad says boy animals have penises. Girl animals have a vagina.
Wow, I didn't realize you could actually like smack down this timer. Yes, hit me up, Geop. I am ready to go.
3, 2, 1, go.
All right, so you're a literal child, and
yeah. You
like to think that you're smart, but you're actually an idiot, right?
What?
Exactly. And because you're such an idiot, you're really subject to whatever marketers tell you. Isn't that right?
I'm telling.
Well, have I got the thing for you? Because this is exactly the thing that all of your stupid child friends are loving right now. They are the coolest looking kids in the entire world.
Is it Pokemon
world.
Go?
It's like Pokemon Go, but it's actually 10 times cooler. And you know, because I wouldn't lie to you, because I'm your friend, right?
Mom said I shouldn't talk to strangers.
Well, fuck, I broke. Well, what I have for you here is something that all the kids are wearing these days. It's slick. It's fashionable. It's amazing. What I have for you is a fashion hood. All it's of the fashion. Kids are wearing them. All of your kids love fashion. All of you kids love hoods for fashion. It is a hood that you put on your head, and it might make breathing hard, but you'll look cool, and that's the important part. Because you're a child.
Does it have Spider-Man?
Yes. Yes, it does.
I like Spider-Man.
The beep is part of the pitch.
Well, that's what gets kids' attention.
Just so you know, this is a child. Like 5 or 6 child.
Right, a stupid child.
Exactly.
Who would laugh at nards.
Wolfman's got
but
nards.
Animal sack.
Thanks for the follow, Sword Girl. And also, I missed Kygon earlier. Thank you. Thank you for the sub, 2-Fort Kid.
Andy.
I'm ready.
Are you ready to talk to a baby?
Yes.
3, 2, 1, baby talk.
Howdy there, sport. What's the matter? You seem a little down. You okay?
Yeah, he's treating me like a kid.
Did the kids beat you up because you wore that fashion hood to school?
Yes.
I bet they did. But it's okay because I've got something that'll make that whole experience a lot better for you.
You gonna beat up the bully?
I'll do the next best thing for you, buddy. I'm gonna sell you clock underwear. You see, bullies have this habit of pulling down the pants. Now, hold on. Bullies have a habit of pulling down your pants and laughing at whatever you're wearing that day. They probably laugh at your Spider-Man underwear, I bet. But with this underwear, it's got a clock in it. And not only does this underwear tell time, it beeps. I'm wearing a pair right now. Watch this.
Mom!
All I'm saying is, you could be the coolest kid on the block.
Stranger's showing me his underwear.
You could be the coolest kid on the block with this set of clock underwear. Don't tell your parents.
I'm scared.
Well, this thing, apparently you can start and stop the timer by hitting it, so gotta be careful.
Oh, are your buttons functional?
Well, I think you press it once it starts and the next one stops.
Honk.
So, child op.
Boop, 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 boop.
You want an animal sack? Clock undies? Or a fashion hood?
Honestly, probably animal sack, because a kid wouldn't care about
I love about the way that he like lovingly rubbed this.
Yes, gentle rub the animal sack.
My hand is so tiny because I'm a child.
Thank you for the
Here you go, you filthy cretin. Howdy, sir. I see you are a wrestler. Is that right?
Oh, brother, yeah.
Yeah, right. Well, let me tell you something. You have your no-holds-barred match where you have to climb up top a ladder to get money that is suspended from a string from the ceiling. Is that correct?
Oh, yeah.
That is terribly unsafe. Now, let me tell you something. There is something I could sell you lessons of that would pay off in dividends. Not only for that, but for also using ladder as a weapon. What I have to sell you, my friend, is ladder safety. You want to know how to operate a ladder like a professional. You want to know how to maintain the balance of a cat atop it like a graceful catwalk. A cat on a catwalk. Yes, that is right. I guarantee you, if you learn ladder safety, you will climb the rungs to the top of the championship. You will win the belt. Do you want the belt, my friend? Do you want the belt, my friend?
Cream of the crop, of course I want the belt.
And you want ladder safety. Da 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 da.
Alright. Vicas, you got it?
I think I do.
Alright, go for it.
Tie Tuesday. Have I ever got a product for Tuesday?
Yeah.
Let me tell you, what is the most important part of a wrestler? Your entrance. Don't even answer that. Everyone knows that. And what do you need to make the most powerful, most impressive, manliest entrance possible? Well, what you need is foam discharge. You see, when you walk out the gate and 500 phallic cannons suddenly shoot out giant white foam all over the arena, all over the audience, absolutely no one will be able to resist you. Whether you are a face, whether you are a heel, you will get them on your side. Fucking, you could be fighting John Cena, and he is going to be covered in your creamy foam discharge. He is not going to be able to fight back. What do you say? You want my discharge?
All right. Andy, are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, go.
Tie Tuesday, the wrestler. Have you been looking for your next big match? I mean, your next big match. You've heard of those things like WrestleMania and Hell in a Cell. Small potatoes. These other two guys try to sell you gimmicks like ladder safety and cum storm, foam discharge, whatever the hell he's trying to sell you. I've got a deal. I've got a match. I have the best match. The final match. If you're not lucky. This match could determine the fate of your career, the fate of your life, the fate of wrestling as we know it. Tie Tuesday, do you want to participate in the suicide cage? A A cage 40 feet up into the air, electrified, covered in pepper, because if you touch it with your eye, it's really gonna hurt. The winner throws the loser off the edge into a vat of sharks. They're all dead, but it's gonna be really gross. And the winner of the suicide cage will receive $29. Now just sign right here. The waiver is yours.
I'm trying to like cover my mouth laughing. I just said that like making fart noises because I can't stop.
It's okay. Let it out. Let it out.
This is very good.
I will take a suicide cage.
I'm just mad I didn't bust out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that was perfect.
That was beautiful and good.
I'm just mad I didn't bust out with a John Cena line, because I could have done that.
Oh, my God. Da, da, da,
da. Hey, this is John Cena! Da, da, da,
da. Suicide cage. All right, Vicas, what do you got?
What do I got? Pervert.
Hey there, how's it going? Oh, Jesus, I just tripped over your gigantic wiener. I'm so sorry. Anyways, you seem to be pretty well endowed. You seem to be... You know what you want, basically.
Oh, I know
I'm saying,
what I want, all right.
You're not wearing pants. I can tell you're a little bit of a pervert, but aren't we all, I'm saying.
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
So, let me ask you something. Have you ever thought about real estate?
Constantly.
I bet you're looking for a nice place to settle down with maybe your wife or any other fellow perverts that...
A nice place to make the fuck, yes.
Yeah, so might I suggest a nice lakeside cottage by Lake Anus. It's got inlets, it's got outlets, and I know these are words you're very familiar with.
Absolutely.
It goes right up to the lake. You can see other perverts everywhere. This is actually the place where they all have to live. I'm not so much selling you something as I'm telling you. The government is saying you have to move to Lake Anus. I you don't have a choice in the matter. You're being relocated on Monday. But just think about it. Just think about maybe some decorations for your place. Maybe a nice little I don't know, vibrator torpedo that you could put out in the water and bring the family around to enjoy.
Those things really can swim.
Yeah, they can.
Geop, are you alive?
Are you ready?
Are you ready?
I was going for last. Are you almost ready?
I've kind of got a bit of a dry round here of things. So I'm trying to make sense of something here.
I will allow a sit out. If you want to sit out and shuffle all your cards, I think that's fair.
It's just this kind of like nonsense. I'm sitting here trying to think of something.
You're a good salesman, Geop. You can sell somebody on it.
Give me a moment.
All right, I'll go ahead and go then.
All right. You ready?
Oh, yeah.
And we will go in 3, 2, 1, go.
Sir, I can tell you're a pervert. But the thing is, well, it's okay, though, because I also am a pervert. I'm a big pervert as well. So the thing is, though, is one pervert to another, I know that, you know, you're no low-tier pervert. You have equipment.
I'm next level.
You have your pervert things. You have your pervert toys. You know, you don't just have a Daikimura. You also have things to slip in there, to slip into. You know, and the thing is, though, is like, that material, you know, it starts to get sticky, it gets a little gross, but here's the thing.
Oh, always.
You can't be getting stuck in your stuff. You got to make sure you can slide in and out, and let's just say nothing is better for that than a little rubber butter. You just rub your rubber butter all up in there, and you're going to be going in and out all night long, and you're going to forget. You're going to forget that it's not a person. Just perfectly moist. It's not going to wear off. You're not going to have to reapply. It doesn't dry out. Nothing stays smooth like a little rubber butter. You're going to glide perfectly on your... You're going to a pleasure town coated in rubber butter.
Ooh, rubber butter.
Rubber butter
at Lake Anus.
Rubber butter. Just, you'll feel like you're rubbing her butter when you're rolling rubber butter.
Beep, beep, beep. Are you ready, Geoff?
Yeah, I'll try and make something else.
All right, and I will start you in 3, 2, 1, go.
Knock, knock, knock.
Hello.
Oh, Jesus Christ, boy, why'd you answer the door with no pants on?
I don't own any pants.
Oh, well, you're unfortunately the perfect sort of customer for what I am trying to sell to you, sir. You see, I can tell you are a bit of a deviant, my friend.
That's, you know what that one word of the labels means? Yeah, that'd be
a sexual deviant, my friend. And I use the term friend very loosely, sir. So let me give you some guidance, friend. You could engage in your lascivious activities inside of your abode, provided you do not propagate to the outside. It is undesirable. It is strange. It is fucking weird. So here is what I have for you. How about something that you could occupy yourself with in the bathtub? Now, I'm not talking about like a vibrator torpedo or some stupid toy nonsense. I'm just talking about regular old tub toy.
Just tub
that
toy.
Is all.
That's all it is.
It's a rubber ducky. There's nothing weird about it. Get your hands away from the guards, boy. I swear to God, I will big stick you.
I like
call the police!
I like these cards a lot.
Rub this dumb toy with some rubber butter.
Let me get the rubber.
I'm actually a very angry door-to-door man.
Let me get the rubber butter on, covering that tub toy real quick. We're going to have a great time, dude. We're going to have a great time. Just let me just stack that in.
Well, as a pervert, I really do need me some rubber butter.
Everyone needs rubber butter, honestly.
That's fair, actually.
Chat asking, is rubber butter just lube? No, it's a very specific lube for a very specific
It'll
man.
Rub you the right.
It's for a very specific type of sweaty.
Protest.
All right, so I hear that you're a professional protester.
I have been called one, yes.
And I have for you not a product. I wouldn't deal in something so lowbrow, really. What I have for you is a cause.
I'm all about causes.
Exactly. See, what if I told you that millions were being murdered each year?
That, you don't have to tell me. I know that. That's what I protest.
That all of this senseless hate is being pushed by just true monsters.
Mm-hmm.
I think that you would get behind that, don't you think?
Behind the violence or behind protesting the violence?
Behind protesting the violence. I think that this is incredibly just wrong and awful that this ever happens, if you ask me.
Mm-hmm.
I think that what we need you protesting, and I think what will be very good for your protesting career, really, really bust your own chops here, is if you were to protest ovum murder. Abortion is a crime!
I've never thought about that.
Murder of ovums, of ovums. Babies, of unborn babies.
Just the eggs. Baby eggs.
Just the eggs. They're all dead. Once a month, every month. Oh my God.
All right, Geop, if you're not ready, I am.
Yeah, go ahead. I'm kind of same as last time. I'm just kind of like,
all right.
Huh? All right.
Yep.
3, 2, 1.
All right, so you're out there, you're in the streets, you're trying to protest some corrupt company, right? So you've got the line, you got the line with your boys, you're all lined up, people trying to get in through. And the other thing, too, you got to worry about is scabs, right? People being hired at triple the rate just to get work done, to try and break your protest, try and break what you're trying to get done. You got people, they start getting unruly, they want to go about their business. You know what stops them all in their tracks, Andy? Do you know what will turn that protest from a disaster with an unruly group of people trying to get where they need to go, people trying to go and get paid? Well, you know what busts that all up? Yeah. So, you know, you got to deal with all that government corruption, all that corporate corruption. You know how you fight back? Your own corruption. Crowd money. Fucking make it rain on them. Clam, smackers, long green. Dump the money in there as deep as you can. Just look at that. Bam, smackers. You think you're not sold yet? Here you go. Look at it. Example picture. Example one. Right here. Crowd money. Dump it on the streets. They'll go nuts. And they'll leave you alone. Crowd money. They'll join the picket line.
Can I take this money for myself?
You could. That's your choice. You could retire on crowd money if you please. Crowd money. Think about it. It's effective. 100%.
Crowd money.
Crowd money.
The heart of darkness is yours to use.
All right. Jip.
I'm just going to have to pass. I've literally got nothing.
You should shuffle your hand out.
You want to reshuffle? Seriously. I think I'm going to have to go with crowd money.
It's 100% effective. Has yet to fail.
Sell me.
Sir, executions, they aren't what they used to be, you know? You used to have to set everything up, tie the rope, really get all the weights in position, get the guillotine set up. You know, it was hard work. You know, it was really backbreaking. Right?
Yeah, there was a science to it. Yeah.
There was a science, and you had to lift, you know, your weights. You got strong from just doing work. What if I told you, because nowadays it's all gas and it's all chairs and everything. There's no physical work to it. You press a button, you strap someone in, give them a bit of a sponge. You know, that kind of thing. So let's just say you want to get your workout, because I'm looking at you and you're a buff executioner. So I can tell you put the time in. What if I told you I could save you so much time and let you get your workout while you're doing your executions? Well, good news for you, friend. Whoa. Exercise sword. You can take him out while you're getting your reps in. No need to lose your gains. It's heavier than a regular sword. It gets the job done twice as fast, and you get your lifts in.
Exercise well, if I sword. May... Mm-hmm. If I may ask you a question.
Absolutely.
Where was it forged?
Where was it forged? Only by the strongest uncles.
What can I do to a swine carcass? I gotta know. Get a middle-aged man out here in a sweaty button-up shirt. I want to see what we can do with some pigs. Oh, you boys have some stiff competition.
I can go.
Okay. Ready. 3, 2, 1, go.
Now, sir, I can see that you're an executioner. It's as plain as the day on your face is, you know? Like, you are the kind of person who really enjoys just murdering people that the state says are bad. But have you ever had the problem where you just, you're at like, I don't know, a 4th of July party and your cousin's uncle's over and you're trying to explain, you know, this is what I do, but they're not quite getting it. You know, liberals, right? Yeah. Well, if you ask me, there really has to be a better way for you to explain that you basically murder people for a living, right? Right? Yeah.
Not even for the money.
I think I have something that would absolutely just paint a sign on you and say that you are borderline psychotic and that you're just doing a job. I take back what I said. I never said that. What you need, sir, is a badge of honor. What you need is a blood belt.
Oh.
You wear this thing to a fireworks show, no family is going to sit within like 30 feet of you. You are going to assert your dominance. You are going to get those lakeside seats. And your fucking cousin's Uncle Billy, he's going to know what you do for a living. You kill.
Is it just covered in blood?
It's just a belt made of blood.
Have a word.
100% blood.
Is it melted blood?
Nothing but blood.
Just thought of melty blood for some stupid fucking reason. So is it melty blood? Andy.
All right. Count me in.
3, 2, 1, go.
Good evening, sir. How are you today?
Oh, I'm doing fine. I'm killing it. How about you?
So you're clearly someone who enjoys their work.
Yeah.
Have you ever wondered how the prisoners think about their executions? It's probably something that you don't really think about too much, because obviously that's not their job. That's your job. You just do the killing, they do the dying. But did you know, statistically speaking, the last thing most people on death row experience is an execution? So we thought, we here at Snake Oil Products thought, what if we had a way to make those last minutes of someone's life, make it a little more fun? That's why we introduced the Tickle Coat. Prisoners are outfitted with this state-of-the-art coat right before lethal injection, electrocution, whatever the method of death is. They wear this coat and they just enjoy a nice light tickling. They die as they laugh. It's really quite astounding. If you've ever liked to see a demo, we'd be happy to schedule one for you. You will need to bring your own prisoner. We do not yet have a patent for the Tickle Coat, so this isn't entirely legal, but it's fun. It's a nice little Tickle Coat. You'll laugh as you die.
Exercise place, man.
Oops.
That was perfectly the edge of my screen.
We're shuffling them now.
Take the fucking card.
Exercise, got it tied. Sword, take the exercise, card. Sword,
I
exercise.
Think it fell off the desk. No, there it
no,
is.
No, it's in it. His hand now.
I'm having some issues now.
Oh no, I dropped my card.
Okay. I was trying to do that.
Hello, friend. I see you are of the adult entertainment industry. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Well, sir, let me tell you, I am here to sell you a script. It is not one that I wrote. This is, in fact, very... It's not my bag, but you know how the economy is these days. You mm-hmm. just have to, you know, you have to get money where you can. You know what I'm saying, son? Mm-hmm.
I do.
You do anything for your money?
Within reason.
Well, I have a script. How would you like to be stuck in a bitch blizzard? Imagine, if you will, the frozen tundra covered in women, but it's horribly cold, you see. This is actually more of a performance art piece. In fact, I don't know how you could perform out in the blizzard, but the bitch blizzard coming this winter. You can do the writing, right? Look, man, I need the money. Just pee, please.
That's a good film idea.
I like it. Bitch blizzard. We're out here in the cold, my friend. We must make love or else we will surely die.
Hi, I'm Gary Queen, and this is the bitch blizzard.
Let me just change my Discord name to Bitch Blizzard.
By the way, I think you... I don't know if you missed my joke about coming.
I got it. All right, who's going next? Who's got a follow up to Bitch Blizzard? Vicas, it's technically your turn. You ready?
It is technically my turn.
All right, 3, 2, 1, do it.
Sir, you look like a porn star.
You're right.
All right, I'm glad I'm right, because this pitch would go nowhere without that. But what you really want to be, you don't want to be cold. Have you ever tried to get a boner in -30? It's awful. It's unfun. It would just be terrible.
It's really hard to get a boner in a bitch blizzard.
That's what I'm saying. What you need is hot. What you need is fucking, oh my God, just incredibly hot. You need fire. Ooh. What you want is to be as hot as humanly possible during the sex fuck, right?
Yes.
I'm right.
Yes.
You want it to be, this just is the absolute hottest that your sexy bits could possibly be. What you need is fire titty. This is the hottest titty that you have ever seen. This titty could like fucking set the moon on fire. The moon is really hard to set on fire. It's fucking made of regolith. Like there's no air up there. You could still set it on fire with this hot titty. I had to steal this from Hugh Hefner's mansion, and I am going to sell you for the low price of $69.99. This fire titty.
Can we knock 30 cents off that?
Absolutely. Just for you.
The fire titty forged in the fires of Mount Poon.
Damn. Got a lot of elemental fuck here tonight.
I know.
All right, Andy, tell me about the wind nipple or something.
I unfortunately do not have any elements.
The earthen dong. The water courser.
Mountain village.
Thank you, Colin, for the fire titty. All right. Andy, I need to start the clock, I guess. Okay. Yeah. All right, go for it.
Sir, as a porn star, you undoubtedly go through all kinds of fluids and materials of varying viscosities in your porn shoots, am I right?
Mm-hmm.
Like there's probably all kinds of oils and creams, let's say.
It's an important part of my work.
Now, normally it takes a while to apply all these fluids and things, right? You have to either have to get a stagehand to set them up or put them on manually. It just takes so long, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's such a waste of manpower. It's such a waste of labor. There's got to be a better way. So we came up with a solution to that. We came up with the pleasure hose. Imagine ranch dressing firing all over the room, 300 PSI. High pressure mashed potatoes, high pressure lubricant, high pressure anything you want. If it fits into the hose, we will shoot it. Now, we have had a few issues where the pleasure hose has caused some injury, but I don't think you can really do any better than a hose that fires creams and oils at such a velocity that sometimes people get hurt. But it's a small price to pay for perfection.
Jesus, this is...
Oh my God.
This is really difficult.
I don't know if we top this.
This is really difficult. This is really difficult.
Those were all really fucking good.
I know.
Fire titty.
Oh my God.
I wish I had pleasure titty so much.
God. I gotta give it to Bitch Blizzard, though. It's a whole blizzard.
A whole blizzard of bitches.
A whole blizzard.
There's probably an actual porn movie named that.
Oh, my.
Probably.
Jesus.
Bitch Blizzard.
Hello, my friend. You are looking quite hot today. In fact, some youngsters might say you were looking very spicy. Is that right?
That's not the first time that's been used to describe me.
Well, okay. Let's see. You've got, what is this? What are you doing here? You got what is this shit? You trying to start a fire here, my friend?
Are you a cop?
Well, if I say no, will I pass the test?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the law.
Okay, I did not burst into flames. So that means I'm not a police officer. It also means you have not elected to kill me. So let me tell you, my friend, what if you want to start fires everywhere? What if you want to become a god of death? What if you want to rain down destruction upon the citizens of this valley?
As long as it's fire related.
Well, I have here something you cannot turn away from. I give you the death kit!
Death kit!
Boy, let me tell you, woo-wee, this is 10 times a combustible material. It's even made out of asbestos. How the hell does that work at first? It's made out of asbestos? I don't know. It's dangerous. It'll probably give you cancer. It's also lined with lead. Don't drink out of it, by the way. It's very deadly. But yes, it will cause wanton destruction. Do you want destruction? Wanton destruction. The death kit, available today from Geop Co.
I'm glad you have a brand now.
Open shut sale, my friend.
Oh, you took that card off, just bitch. Right on the top.
All right, Andy, you want to go?
Titty bitch.
All right.
Please stop making a large titty on the table.
Large the titty.
I have trouble all right. focusing.
All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, and you'll go in 3, 2, 1, go.
Sir, I'm not going to waste your time on this one. You're clearly very busy. You've got a lot of things to burn down, allegedly, of course. I'm not saying you would ever do that, wink, wink. But have you ever had the problem where you've got too much money, right?
Constantly.
You keep burning stuff down, and all your money, it catches on fire in the blaze.
It does.
Like you just can't get any money when you're burning everything down. But I've got a solution for that. It's the money locker. Instead of just burning everything down, you put it into the money locker, presumably money.
Mm-hmm.
'Cause what are you going to do? Put your money in the banks? You burn those out all the time. Put it in your house? Again, burn down. This money locker is made out of fire-resistant steel. It's made out of fire-resistant lead. It's made out of fire-resistant everything. Nothing can burn down this locker, which makes it a very exciting challenge for you. Can you burn down this locker, sir? Can you do it?
If not, I might have to find out.
It'll provide excellent training, but we guarantee you will not burn down this locker. You cannot burn anything inside this locker. You can hide anything in there. Nobody will get there. Money, you can hide people, you can hide anything, but the fire will never get through to it. Will you get through to the locker? That all depends if you call now.
Beautiful.
I have a question. Jet fuel burn through it.
Oh, no.
Jet fuel does not melt steel.
I'm just a man in search of the truth.
All right. I'm ready.
You are ready. All right. Then we'll go in 3, 2, 1, go.
Vicas, people don't appreciate your art. They don't respect it.
No.
People think pyromaniacs. First of all, I don't like that term. I like to think of them as pyro artists, flame workers. You see beauty in what you do. Other people do not. There's many types of fires, too. You know, you can burn out a building for the large spectacle. You got some very small fires for practice. But there's a beautiful middle ground where you have the most display possible, where everyone can get to it and everyone is.
Ooh.
And that's when you light a truck on fire. It's a classic. It's good. It's appreciable. It's something everyone's going to notice and has to be dealt with. But it's
a fire on wheels.
Not too much damage. It's a fire on wheels. It's a perfect balance. But then you get the fire department coming in, the cops trying to turn off your truck fire. They try and hit it with water. Well, buddy, I got something for you. It's going to keep it burning. It's truck spray. It's going to burn for days. They'll never put that truck out. Your artwork will stand the test of time. No longer will people wash away your hours of preparation of getting the truck to burn just right. Oh, what's that? You put a bunch of copper in the truck so it would burn a beautiful green? That's a blessing. They deserve to see all of it. Make sure it lasts with truck spray.
Truck spray.
No G Gundam references? Boy.
Truck of mine is burning red.
This fire of mine burns.
Got the money locker.
Awesome power. Please call the police.
This hurts a lot. Ooh, what do I give this to? Shit. Hmm.
Death kid.
You're a firefighter. What's the number one problem you run into? That's right. Probably burning yourself on stuff. So you got your fire equipment and they got your helmet. They have your respirator. They have your protection from almost every side. But here's the thing. Even when you're in that gear gets real hot, right? Even inside of it, you're not burnt, but you're very hot.
Boiling hot. I feel like a fire titty.
Yeah, like a fire titty. So what is the worst thing that happens when you're trapped in a suit of like a rubbery material and you're
ball
hot?
Soup.
Oh, that's right, dude. You got swamp bottom. You got the roast ass. You got the drenched cheeks. Well, good news, buddy. We're going to protect that bottom and we're going to keep you dry with the butt pad. Simple. To the point. You're going to be dry as the day you were your driest. It's going to be great down there. You're going to feel great. You're going to leave. Everyone else is going to be like, oh, I got a shower. And you're going to be like, I feel like I could do some stuff with my ass. You're going to have a great time after firefighting.
I never get to do stuff with my ass.
You're right. It's going to be nice. This is going to keep you at a perfect temperature. It's air conditioned. You got an air conditioned ass. Everyone else is. You're going to be the envy of the whole place. Oh, everybody, we're riding out in the fire truck. Who wants to be on the bumpy seat? And then here comes Andy in the back. I can volunteer this time. You're a hero. You're a hero with a perfect ass with the butt pad.
God bless America.
Yeah, Vicas might have to go ahead. I'm having second thoughts.
Mm. All right.
All right, you ready, Vicas?
I'm as ready as I'll ever be.
All right, 3, 2, 1, butt pad.
All right, Mr. Firefighter.
That's my last name.
I assume that you are very well educated on the arts of fire. Do you know what the number one cause of fire in the home and abroad is?
It's water, right?
Actually, no. What it really is missles.
Oh.
See, missiles, they don't just cause, you know, like, there aren't your local pyromaniac. I have no idea who he is. But anyway, they're not little things. They cause big fires. They go boom, and there's like fire in the sky. There's fire everywhere. There's fire falling down on your dog. Your dog's on fire. It's fucked up. It's really fucked up.
I hate when that happens.
Right? You, the firefighter. Honestly, I know your job is really sort of like, you know, to fight the fires that are happening, but what if you could get into the business of fire prevention?
Mm-hmm.
What if you got a missile controller?
Ooh.
Using this, you can take control of any missile within, let's say, 300 meters. Let's say, you know, any missile you come across, like American nuclear silos, sure. Cruise missiles, anything. You can control it. You can make sure it never launches, or you can launch it over into your neighbor's backyard. You know, fuck Jim, right?
Can I control vibrator torpedoes?
We are actually still working on that feature, but we assume it will be in quite soon.
I'll have to look at your website.
Yeah, fuck Jim.
Yeah, fuck that guy. Fuck Jim. Thanks for the butt pad, Rush.
All right, jump.
Okay, I'm ready.
All right, 3, 2, 1, fire.
Hello, fireman. I have a question for you. It is not about your occupation. It is actually more about your home life. You like computers, my friend?
I like to post online every now and then.
Do you ever find an issue with your computer overheating? You see, this is a problem. Overheating is a fire that you cannot fight with a hose, my friend.
I tried it once, didn't end well.
That is correct. What you need is something very, very different. You know what works well on fires?
Tell me more. Tell me more!
I want to give you a computer fan, and not just any computer fan. This is the
the biggest fan you've ever seen, my friend.
It's in a secret zone. You can't show it there.
It keeps changing into a card that says snake oil. This is incredible.
Hang on.
Does that happen every time? If you're offering it to me
a little something.
If you're offering me the fan for free, I'll take it.
Man, I'm giving you fan service.
Well, Geop, I gotta say, I'm a big fan. Do I give it to the incredibly large computer fan, the missile controller, or the butt pad?
Butt pad, woo!
I think it's gonna have to be the butt pad.
That's a fair one.
It's
very practical.
I don't think you can flick it out of his secret zone.
Geop intercepted it. It's the butt pad.
All right, quick count, I suppose.
I got 2, so I definitely lost.
I have 6.
4.
3.
Good rounds. That was a lot of shit that happened tonight.
I enjoy shit happening.
Ty, do you want to press the end the world button?
Fuck this game!
I got the clock.
You made a new table, and it's a pervert table.
There it goes.
No,
pervert table.
Down to pervert table.
Good night, everybody.
The clock.
There she goes again.